Hi, I'm Lee Allison, the director of the Arizona Geological Survey, state geologist of Arizona. Starting in March of 2016, we've started seeing an earthquake swarm in the northwest part of the state, something that we haven't really seen here before, in part because we haven't had instruments out there that could detect small earthquakes in remote areas. In recent years, we've been able to deploy a network of seismometers across the state, and working with similar networks in Utah and Nevada, we are now able to monitor small earthquakes in parts of the state where we never knew what was going on before. So it's possible these kinds of swarms have gone on in the past, and we just didn't know about it. But it's an unprecedented opportunity for us to learn about earthquake hazards and risks in this part of the state and what it may mean for the rest of Arizona. So, of the 57 earthquakes we've seen so far, the largest is a magnitude 3.8. That's not large enough to cause damage, but people did feel it, not only in Arizona, but over in Nevada. When we've seen earthquake swarms like this in other parts of the country and around the world, generally we don't see that they lead to a much larger earthquake that's very destructive or damaging. Typically, the ones we've seen stay about the same size of earthquakes. This is also a chance for us to monitor these, analyze the results, and learn from this. This part of the state is at the southern end of what's called the Intermountain Seismic Belt. It's an area of high earthquake activity that runs from Montana, down through Idaho, all the way through Utah, and dies out in northwestern Arizona. It's the eastern boundary of the Great Basin region, which stretches all the way to the Sierra Nevada Mountains in California and the Reno area. It's where the crust is being stretched and pulled apart, and it's been pulling apart like this for over 15 million years. So we expect it's going to continue going on for quite a while longer. But we're at that boundary where the crust is being stretched and pulled, and as we stretch the crust out, it breaks. And parts of the basins drop down, mountains are popping up relative to it, and what we call normal faults occur in between the basins dropping down, the mountains coming up. And that's the kind of activity we're seeing out here. So it's not unexpected, but it is giving us a chance to remind us that we do live in earthquake country. We may not have as often an earthquake as they do in California, or as big as they often do, but in the historic past, we've seen earthquakes as big as a magnitude 7.5 causing damage across parts of Arizona. We need to be prepared. Prepared at home, at the office, for our kids at school. Have an emergency preparedness kit. Have a plan on what to do if the phone lines are out, if utilities are down, and your family's scattered around. Also, in the event of an earthquake, your first reaction should be drop, cover, and hold on. Get below a heavy desk or table. You want to protect yourself from falling objects. So something else you should do at home is to secure your water heater, bolt it into the walls with a plumber's tape or something like that. If you have heavy objects, big TVs or heavy bookcases, you want to make sure they're secured to their stand or secured to the walls. Every year, Arizona participates in the Great Shakeout. This is a nationwide event. Millions and millions of people participate. We've had hundreds of thousands of people in Arizona participate. This year, it'll be October 20th, and at a certain time in the morning, we invite everybody to stop. Practice that. Duck under a desk, duck under a table. Remind your family to do it. Encourage your kids to do it in their classrooms, your colleagues at work. And just as a reminder, to be prepared and know what to do in the event of an earthquake.